Good morning, students of Parkway Elementary School. This is your coach, Coach Noel. How are you today, kids? Hope you are doing fine. In my previous video, we learned about the fundamental skills in dribbling, at the same time, fundamental skills in ball handling and ball control. So in my next video, kids, we're going to learn the different drills in making a shot using one-handed shot or using the two-handed shot. Okay, I'm going to show you how to do it. Come on, join me in doing this kind of basketball activity, kids. So first, I need to position myself that is closer to the goal or closer to the ring. So I need to use my strong hand. So if you are right-handed, you can use your right hand. But if you are left-handed, you can use your left hand as well. So this time, focus on is the one-handed shot. Okay, so I need to carry the ball with my open palm like this. And of course, I need to push the ball towards the goal, towards the ring, using my wrist and of course, my fingertips. Okay, we're going to make this one with Nintendo skis. Here we go. One. So we're done with the one-handed shot, kids, in front of the ring or the goal. Okay, kids, let's now proceed to the second shooting skills for today. So a while ago, I need to shoot the ball in front of the goal or in front of the ring. This time, I'll be on the right side of the ring, so I need to position myself on this area. So again, I need to use my strong hand, which is the right hand. So I need to shoot the ball using one hand. So opposite to it, I need to bounce the ball on the glass or on the board like this one. Okay. So again, I need to make 10 shots. Here we go. One. As you can see, kids, I need to throw the ball on the square in front of the ring. Three. Okay, kids, so let's now proceed to the shooting drill number 3. So we call this one again as one-handed shot. So the first one, while I go, I need to shoot the ball using one hand in front of the goal or in front of the ring, followed by shooting the ball using one hand still at the right side of the ring, and this time I'll be on the left side. Okay, here we go. Again, still I need to use my strong hand, which is the right hand, since I'm a right-handed. Okay, here we go, kids. Again, we need to shoot the ball using one hand, and see if we're going to use the board as we you do this one. So we're done with activity 1, 2, and 3, kids. So shooting using one-handed shot as we do the boarding shot. Okay. Okay, kids. Let's now proceed to the fourth shooting skills for today. One-handed shot. So this time, I need to use two hands in shooting the ball. So the other hand will support the ball and, of course, the other hand, which is my right hand, this strong hand, will still be the one to push the ball up straight into the air. Okay, here we go, kids. Again, I'm going to position myself in front of the ring. So, I need to support using my left hand. As you can see, the right hand still hold the ball. And of course, my left hand will hold the ball to control the ball as I do the shooting. Okay, here we go, kids. One. When you make the shot, you need to bend your knees also so that okay, so we're done with shooting the ball using two hands in front of the ring or in front of the goal. Okay, kids, let's now proceed to shooting drills number 5. So this time I need to shoot the ball using my two hands on the left side of the board. Okay. So here we go, kids. In shooting the ball, I need to situate. I'm going to support again the ball using my left hand. And of course, I need to aim the target, which is the square. So in doing this kind of activity, I need to hold the ball using my strong hand, which is the right hand. And of course, left hand will be the one to support. And of course, I need to take the shot by aiming the target with this square so that it will be easy for me to make a basket. Okay, so you're going to aim up for this. In making a basket, always bounce the ball on the board or on the glass before it will go into the basket. Okay, here we go. One. Two. Number 4, 5, 6, 7, on the check piece on the right side of, or on the left side of the ring. Okay, kiddos, let's now proceed to shooting drills number 6. So still shooting using two hands. So this time I need to position myself on the right side of the ring. Okay, so take note, kids, you need to bend your knees, aim the target, and push the ball on the square, or let the ball bounce on the square, on the backboard, and of course, it's easier for us to make the shot. Okay, here we go. Shooting the ball, it's easier for us to make a basket if we're going to use the board in making our shot. Okay. Okay, kids, let's now proceed to activity number 7, which is the shooting in a free throw line. Okay. Okay, in making your free throws, you're going to stand in front of the goal or the ring, then of course you're going to aim your target, and of course you need to bend your knees once you throw the ball up straight into the air. Okay, to make the shot. Okay, here we go, kids. One. Very important also, kids, to make your follow through if you're going to release the ball and aim for the target. And of course, don't forget to bend your knees. Okay, kids, let's now proceed to shooting drill number 8. So we call this one as the finger roll layup. Okay, so as you can see, I have a cone on this one, so I need to jump using my left leg, and of course I need to raise my right leg to get my balance. Okay, so here we go, guys. You're going to use your right hand if you're right-handed, left hand if you're left-handed. Here we go. One. Thank you. square down into layup. Okay, kids, this will be the 9 shooting drill. So this time I need to use the right side of the ring to do the layup. Again, I need to use my left leg in jumping, and of course I need to raise my right leg to keep my balance and do the layup. Okay, here we go, kids. So we're done with the layup, kids. So we're done with activity number 9. Okay, kiddos, finally we're done to the 10 and final shooting drills for today. So I need to use the left side of the ring. So I need to do the layup once again. And of course, I'm going to use my left leg in taking off, and of course I need to raise my right foot in order to keep my balance and do the layup. Take note, kids, in doing the layup, it's easier for us to make the basket if we're going to use the board before we go in the layup, rather than directly finger roll the ball into the basket. Okay. Okay, kids, so we're done with the 10 and final shooting drills for today. Okay, kids, so we are done with 10 shooting drills for today. So I hope you can do this one at home. So if you have a basketball with you can use them, especially if you have ring inside your house or at your backyard or front yard or any part that is very close to your home. So you can go there and try doing this kind of activity. So if the regular size of a basketball is too heavy for you, you can use a small basketball. And of course, if you have also a ring that is a little bit lower compared to the regular height of a basketball, You can use that one also. So, see you again in my next video, 4th grade and 5th grade. This is your gym teacher, Mr. Salinda. Bye for now. God bless.